Start. Sir, I thank you for the opportunity that you have given me to say a few words on the budget that has been presented by the Finance Minister. At the outset, I must say that we are grateful to him for some relief that he has given us in the budget. At the same time, we are thankful to him also for a statement that he will not resort to deficit financing. Let us hope that the pattern of budget in future will be based on the budget that has been presented now. We have been having a period of economic stress and strain during the last few months, especially on the food front. Fortunately, we have had a good crop both of wheat and rice, and we hope that we will be able to import sufficient quantities of rice and wheat to tide over our difficulties for the rest of the year. But in spite of all these things, the prices are rising. I would urge upon the Finance Minister and the Planning Commission to keep a watch on the price situation so that we may see that the prices do not rise too much. Then I would like to deal with the question of deficit financing. As we are aware, it has been the cause of inflation all these years. I am glad that a good lead has been shown in this year's budget, and I hope and trust that the Finance Minister will not think of deficit financing anymore. But that is not enough. It should be realized that if more money is made available, there will be more chances of inflation. In view of this, the Finance Ministry and the Planning Commission should have strict control over the inflationary tendency and stop it at the level at which it should be done. I would like to refer to the question of indirect taxation. It will be found that the Finance Minister has given some relief in respect of cloth and some other items. There is no doubt that this will bring down the prices of articles. At the same time, I wish to point out that the masses want him to give some relief in respect of kerosene. In this connection, I would like to point out that the high excise duty on kerosene is causing great hardship to the people in the rural areas. So, I would appeal to the Finance Minister to consider whether it will be possible for him to give some relief so far as kerosene is concerned. Now, I come to the question of civil expenditure. I am grateful to the Finance Minister for some economy that he has made in civil expenditure during the last year. At the same time, I think there is still scope for him to consider whether it is possible to make some more economy in whichever ministry or departments it is possible to do so. So far as the question of pay scales of central government employees is concerned, I agree with those who feel that our employees should be paid well. At the same time, I have to point out that the Finance Minister should take an overall picture of the whole country. In this connection, it should be borne in mind that if the central government employees get more than the employees of the state government, there will always be discontent. So, I would request the Finance Minister to find ways and means so that a man with equal qualification may be able to get equal pay wherever he is placed. Letter from Kesavan and Company, Mumbai, to Messrs. Guhan and Company, Mysore. Dear Sirs, we have received your order this morning, for which we are much obliged to you. We take this opportunity to assure you that we will send in 2 or 3 days some of the goods ordered by you. As regards the other goods, we have to inform you that they are at present out of stock, but we would like to tell you that we expect to receive these goods from our manufacturer towards the end of this week. So we are confident that we will be able to cause it to you on account of this delay. We hope you will not remind this delay. We have no doubt that we will continue to have your patronage in future. On this occasion, we wish to bring to your notice that we propose to procure some new articles which will be of use to the people in your locality. We enclose a list of these items towards with their proposed prices. As soon as we get those goods, we shall inform you. In the meantime, we have instructed our representative who is on tour in your district to meet you and give further details in this regard, so that you may be able to appreciate the usefulness of these articles. Yours faithfully. Stop.